All right. I don't know if this is more or less distracting than it could be, this black and white thing, but I don't want to set up the green screen right now, so I'm just kind of I'm doing something that is like, I guess I don't even really need this light. Yeah, it's kind of film noir. Trying to, I don't know, I'm just recording this for, this is the universe mode. It's just something to document the universe mode. I think we can hear everything here. But yeah. I didn't do any divisions or anything like that on here. I just put in the wrestlers that are in AEW or an extension of AEW and made the tag teams. I haven't even done all the tag team entrances or anything like that, but this is just what it spit out to me. Then I figure I'll do these matches and just see what happens. This is what it gave me. So we got Jeff Hardy versus Pac in the first one. Jesus versus Hook, the second one. And I did change this because it was Juice versus Billy Gunn, and I didn't really want to have Billy Gunn in a feud in this particular universe. I'm trying to stick to the guys that are mostly full time here. So Adam Cole versus Ethan Page, Claudio versus Brody, and then Preston Vance versus Kenny Omega versus Lee Moriarty in this main event. So we don't quite have the ramifications of what all this is gonna mean yet. Let's see the news. Oh yeah, I haven't even hit all of this yet. So news, no news. Historical stats, yeah, we don't care about that. But yeah, just to kind of give a rundown of what we have on the calendar here. Dynamite and Rampage on Wednesday and Friday, and then we've got Double or Nothing at the end of May. I was gonna put Forbidden Door, but I honestly don't really have enough New Japan wrestlers on here yet. I have a few on here, but maybe if I get some more, we can throw in Forbidden Door on here and kind of build it. Then we get to the beginning of September, and then we have All Out, Full Gear, and towards the end of November, and then back around to Revolution at the end of March. The match cards on all these shows are pretty cool. We'll see what happens. I did do some custom matches. I mean, I don't want to go through all of it right now because I kind of want to just do this episode just to get it over with. It's pretty late for me. So I kind of want to do it just to say we started. But we do have. I will show the championships that we do have. As you can kind of see there at the bottom, we're doing the. I mean, this we're doing straight AEW with this. AEW World Title, TNT Title, International Title, Tag, ROH World Title, and the ROH TV Title, and then we've got a like a Money in the Bank type of brass ring face of the Revolution ladder match, which is the face of the Revolution route ladder match does happen at Revolution, so that's gonna be, that's gonna be a thing as well. So, anyway, that's what we're cooking with. And I, like I said, I didn't do any divisions or power rankings. I'm just kind of letting it dictate, and we'll maybe get into it if I have to, but we're gonna rock it, see what happens. But yeah, this is a weird show. But let's rock today. Jeff Hardy versus Pac. So I'm gonna be rocking everybody's entrance music and stuff on here as well. So let's rock it. Unassigned because I'm not gonna be playing. We're just gonna let it simulate. down with this pack. I had to do a little bit of editing with it, but I got a good pack going on here. I feel like he's pretty solid. This Jeff Hardy is obviously very cool. Okay, I think we're good to go. Let's just ready. Let's not go AEW Dynamite.
Before this match starts, maybe some good sportsmanship.
No entrances. Pack smacks Jeff Hardy.
Hey, maybe they shouldn't have taken the bait, right?
I agree with you, Cole. These two can't.
We've got a WWE ref. That's stupid. I've got to go change that.
Completely disrupted this match.
But now these superstars look ready for even more action.
Look, Cole, it's just business here. No need for the niceties or handshakes or hugging it out.
I'm just pointing out a lack of common courtesy here, Corey.
So we definitely got the slap going on there.
Don't forget that. The time for niceties can be after the bell, if they so choose to see fit.
This is a crazy match to get our first Dynamite going up here. Jeff Hardy.
Deep arm drag. Nice buster.
X-Factor.
That was vicious.
That was a hell of a maneuver there, guys. And well-timed maneuver there. He's taken some good hits. These two showing how well scouted they each are. Set them up for the flatliner. Get prepared to face for that. Right in the mouth, relentless. Right in the face.
My God.
Turning the momentum to his favor.
That's what he does.
Oh,
keep
shoot.
On the.
Taking flight.
Splash. Got a couple of high flyers here. Definitely could be very fun.
He's returning fire.
Now's a chance for him to get back into this match. Landed neck first.
Slam down.
What's he gonna do here?
I also don't really plan on doing like much commentary type stuff over
and
this. I'm just gonna
legal,
watch
so
it.
Hopefully, this will be a short trip outside.
I will say stuff.
Suplex. He's looking a little off balance. These consecutive attacks have him reeling.
He can't just think of.
I really like this one.
He has
to
get on offense.
Something of a competitive edge has been brewing between these superstars lately. A drive to prove who really has the upper hand here.
Their competition can really bring out the best in people, and I think we will be seeing that from them here and
just
completely off target there. That was playing with fire and getting burned.
The decision to take such a risk at this juncture is questionable.
And now thrown back into the ring.
I really like the new Dynamite setup.
And the ref gets hit with an unintentional shot there.
The ref got knocked.
The arms are up.
Oh, shoot. Suplex.
I wish you could add custom refs on there because I found a good Aubrey.
Up and down. Brutal.
Uh-oh. What's next?
Uh-oh.
I love how they say shooting star.
Does he have him here?
It's not.
Performance.
Gotta have the theme songs ready.
Foot to the gut. He's getting pushed out into the defensive. Not a bad place to be in, but the longer this goes, the more trouble a superstar exposes themselves to. He's tied up. German suplex.
Yeah.
into the corner. Oh. This can't be good.
And now he's taken control. Yeah, this match is in his favor now. Able to reverse. Oh, no. Now possibly setting up for a submission maneuver.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. He's got him in the brutalizer.
Strength here.
Jeff is in bad shape.
Not meant to bend that.
Trying to reverse the pressure.
How is Jeff doing this right now?
Finding the mark. He's a free man. Headlock takeover. Slowing down the pace. Tremendous pressure on the head and neck.
This is just an overwhelming amount of offense on him.
Yeah, and he keeps struggling to slow the opposition down.
Oh, Jeff.
Oh my God. Springboard moonsault.
What else can Pac do? He's done what he can so far.
He heads outside. Countouts legal in this match. Drop kick to the back.
Never saw it coming.
And he's able to reverse.
Oh. Yikes.
Saw that one coming.
And both athletes showing that they have each other's number.
Oh, far into the match, and he isn't letting up.
Don't get the sense he's tapping into another level here, and it could pay off.
Snap. I don't know if I've ever seen Jeff be so strike heavy. Kicks. Took a little page out of
Axel.
Danger of a countout, dude. What?
And he tosses him back in now. He climbs back into the ring just in time.
That was getting close.
It's about to go down. Oh! Oh! He down. He down.
Picture perfect execution. Two.
Oh, Jeff.
Say this result isn't going to change things on the disrespect front anytime soon.
That was what you call a statement win, gentlemen. They just put the whole locker room on notice. Respect is earned, not given. Hell, you can even try and take it.
All right. We got some things going on. Good match. Good match. Meltzer gave it 3.5 stars. So why is Edge the only one? Edge is a user. Stop it now, but I do want need to line this up right. Okay, who's this hook? That's a fucking, what's the name of that song? Chairman's Intent. Let's just have some ad. Okay, it doesn't. Sweet. Alright. Let's roll.
Things are about to get good.
making his way to the ring from Lake Forest, Illinois, weighing in at 218 pounds, Rock Constitution Robinson.
The incredible accomplishments,
storied feats of strength, the pure talent of this individual is just astonishing.
Wait, did they write that down for you to read on air? Like, it sounds exactly like what I heard them saying in the mirror backstage.
A man who always gets a strong reaction from the WWE Universe, and it will only intensify once the bell rings.
Dream Weaver. All right.
Wow. And his opponent from New York, weighing in at 202 pounds. Oh.
We're looking at some of the most intense competitors in all of WWE, about to take part in one of the most anticipated matches ever.
Can I say that? I see that that's not a like head like image.
He's been demanding this match for quite some time, and now he is ready to compete.
Kind of similar to what he does, but... Alright, let's go.
We've got one of the most outspoken superstars on the roster in the ring right now.
Yeah, Cole, he's made it very clear what his intentions are and that no one is going to stop him.
They might be intentions, but only time will tell if he's a man of his word.
And he is up against someone who is determined to get the win here, no matter what.
As both men should be, Saxton. If you're not trying to win, you're not trying. Period. Oh, man! What a nasty STO.
I like this about this hook.
The damage he's taking is starting to pile
creation up. Is that his moveset is good. He's got all the suplexes and flips and stuff.
Oh, strong impact.
This is an interesting matchup too.
Whoa, a single arm back body drop.
You don't even know me.
Oh no. Look at them. Oh my god. Oh, wicked kick to the lower back.
Dang dude, is this gonna be a squash?
Oh my gosh.
Dang dude.
Knee driven right through the face and again.
Lifting with these knee strikes.
And he goes for the pin. And he is saved by the ropes.
Letting his opponent know he can take on the world right now.
This is an incessant attack being brought to him. This is where his fortitude will be put to the test. Block the effort and cut them off with a shot to the gut.
Your body. That's what that was.
He's getting a little battered now. Beautiful takedown into the Achilles lock. I'm gonna tap out here.
But the pressure on the left knee. He's trying to fight it. He's trying to break out and does it.
Might have a count out situation here. Because Hook can't stop beating Juice's ass.
He leaves the ring, but he could lose this match. I know I've already said it, but
also we're going to really love the way this arena looks.
Oh, it's not going to be good. This is not going to be good. Jeez,
that was nasty.
Yikes. Juice resorting to some old school type violence here.
Oh, it gets put into the barricade.
Ruthless striking.
Oh. And then he gets right back up.
He is mentally and physically exhausted now.
Oh.
There is no way this can go on for much longer.
Juice is juiced. They're juicing on national television right here.
Oh. He's got the answer for that one. Need to hustle back to the ring. Just a few seconds left. Oh, I saw it coming.
Hook just hit him with a shoot uppercut.
Oh, desperate attempt here to get back on his feet.
Oh,
I don't know what was gonna happen right there, but
here is your winner.
That was weird.
Completed his count, and we have a winner. The winner looks a bit let down.
I kind of like that he hit him with an uppercut.
Perhaps he should have tried to break the count at the end there.
He almost broke the count. He was gonna do something crazy and do a dive out to the outside. He didn't end up doing it. But. All right, Hook gets a dub. So Hook and Jeff Hardy, first winners. So most of these, oh yeah, see these, okay, we've got two rival actions. I don't know, I didn't set all of these up. I think I might have tweaked one of them, but both of these, or most of these, were all set up on their own, so. Let's set up the songs. I will never let go of my ego. Yeah, I know. You know, it's all about the boobs. You know, it's all about the boobs. All right. I guess except, I don't know. Ooh. So we're going to get a return the disrespect situation here. Unassigned. Whatever the elf that means. Oh, okay.
Oh, look at the baby shake hands to start this match. Good sportsmanship here.
Yeah, I like to see this. I don't like that.
Sportsmanship. This is so what I like
Page.
To see. Let him fight.
Well, that's going to fire him up for sure.
Adam Cole kind of looked like the bad guy here.
They should have known better than to take the bait.
Yeah, it's clear there's a total lack of respect between these two.
And it looks like no love these competitors based on that display we just saw.
I just cannot believe the referee is the
second most.
Lack
of respect. That makes the second.
On the ropes, referee breaks the count.
All right. I like this matchup of Ethan Page and Adam Cole.
Oh, man, he has fired up now.
Both good player models here, for sure.
Ducking out of trouble. Every maneuver being returned with counter fire.
Oh, shoot. What's happening right here?
Knee lift! Into the neck breaker!
That was weird.
Chop to the chest.
Pulls in the arm and
Interesting move. And shoulders are down. Two. Powers through after two. Not yet. Saving us from having to sit through that. Hits up with a gut-wrench suplex. What impact. Wicked kick to the face. Now he's been put on the defensive. Gets him with the counter. Planted with a neck breaker. Just rake in the face. Face rake. This is nasty.
Now that was a very questionable attack. I think it goes beyond any gray area.
And now he's giving you all another chance to simply take it all in.
He's doing the Young Bucks. Is that supposed to be some kind of symbol? Oh,
what a punch.
That's how you stop your opponent.
Planning on what to do next.
Ethan Page does have some strength like that.
Oh, callous rake. You can see the marks forming already. He just isn't being given any room to recuperate.
In this situation, he has to get resourceful.
Neckbreaker seemingly out of nowhere.
Neckbreaker out of nowhere. Like an RKO.
Looking wobbly in the corner.
Big time move coming up. Reversal. Can they go on the attack? Looks like some words have been exchanged.
Body language is telling me they might not have been the kindest. Oh, this could be something.
Blast shot.
That kind of move makes a statement.
Cover. He manages to kick out. What strength. No telling how much surviving that will cost, though.
Someone kicks out of that. I don't know how you can still be standing.
That was the home run shot that got robbed at the fence. Up high. Oh, misses the mark. He's going for the pin. This could be it. Into the bay window.
Wow.
Has the opposition in the palm of his hand and he knows it.
Oh.
He steers clear of contact.
Doesn't work out exactly.
Step up in, Zagiri. He's on his heels a bit now.
At this stage of the match, they are clearly starting to feel the effects of this back and crazy forth.
Suplex.
Look at this, just unloading.
Oh, nasty stop to finish it off. And he's just having his way in this match.
He's looking relentless.
Wow.
Down face first. Brutal stomp to the body, and just getting started. Look at this brutality.
This is how you torture your opponent.
Oh my God, this is hard to watch. And that was an effective attack, guys.
Was ready for that.
Setting him up for the shin breaker. He's reminding his competition that they'll only ever be second best.
He's
expressing pain now.
This is getting hard to watch, guys. We might need to stop this one.
And that was a precisely measured attack.
It's time.
He's taking some serious hurt, but somehow he's still in this.
I think he managed that kick out on pure instinct alone.
I can see it in the eyes from here. Disbelief. Unbelievable how this one is still going on.
Two.
Oh, suicide. That was insane. Reckless abandon being shown.
And paying off as well.
Insulting. I don't know how there is anything left in these superstars' bodies.
Yeah, the tank is being emptied tonight.
Sight set on the top rope. From the top. Misses.
He's able to fend off the attack.
Vicious right forearm. And he's able to counter.
Weird.
Ooh, stiff punch. And he sends him into the corner. Victim here to a charge of attacks.
Yeah, the defects in his game are leaving him vulnerable.
Pat, that one's scouted.
He could be turning his fortunes around.
He's stalking his opponent from the top turnbuckle.
Accidental smash. The uncle butched him. Hit him with the butch.
Butchy. Position here.
Where's the honor in that?
There's been plenty of action in this match, and the cost of that is really showing up.
Corey Graves and Byron Stox, them all work for AEW now.
Just aggression, just pure brutality.
Easy.
That'll be the pay for.
Obviously not about the rest count, Cole.
Where are we at on the count?
He's staring his opponent down, getting into that zone.
He's back in so close to a count out. You do not want to lose that way.
He didn't want to do another one of those. That would have sucked.
Target in the arm. This has got to hurt. He takes control.
Ethan Page. Hangman Ethan Page.
Placing them right where they want them, into the corner.
Dang, these two are having a banger on Dynamite.
Taking a moment to let the crowd know how much he appreciates that. Shot to the chest.
Super kick! He may get the three count right here. This is it.
Oh, he got him in it. Amazing match, 4-star match. That was a great match, though. These two could definitely have a crazy match as well. What happened? It was supposed to be Claudio versus Brody King, and then it just became Claudio versus Swerve Strickland. What the fuck is that? Uppercut swing finny. Swerve. Okay. I don't know what's going on with this Swerve situation. It was supposed to be Brody, so I guess we'll see what's going on. Cody O's Castle in that hole.
This is a match with major stakes.
I'm confused though.
Washington, weighing in at 210 pounds.
The WWE Universe already reaching a fever pitch upon their arrival. We are just seconds away from a highly anticipated match.
The last game, or is this Seth Rollins or something? Looks good though. Works.
Says it's all about dominance tonight and plans on showing why everyone backstage should be scared.
I don't know what was up with that Brody King deal though. I'm confused by that. We'll see what happens.
And here's a superstar that has all the tools to be one of the biggest names this business has ever seen. I'm not ready to crown him as the next big thing just yet, but his performance in this match could sway me.
Next big thing.
You're not the only person to be looking to convince tonight, but he's going to be facing one superstar who's always evolving. He told me earlier that he's looking to showcase some new moves in this match tonight. Not the prettiest thing you'll ever see, but it sure looks effective from here.
A giant swing!
Firm control. Big boom. He had it scouted.
I had to edit Claudio's body too to kind of make it look a little more realistic.
Wrapping the arm too big, over that top rope.
The one that I downloaded.
Attacking the arm. That kind of force in the arm.
His face is not perfect, but looks good in game.
Pop up into the kick. Very nice. The better part of valor. Now taking control. Well, this isn't going to win the fall, but it's going to do it. We're going to free the arm and does just that. Brought out of ringside,
fall.
Back to the mat.
Is this supposed to be a Iron Man match or something?
Did you see that? Propelled through the air. Ow! This crowd is truly unworthy of his incredible...
He is not going to let him make a mockery of things.
Goes into the pen. He's nowhere near ready to stop.
Gotta make sure we
yet.
Go in and change the ref after this.
Oh, look at this incredible power.
Gut wrench suplex.
Combination. Not done yet.
Combination.
Another?
Man, you're observant, Byron. Best analyst in the game.
How about one more?
And the superstar's opponent is helpless.
Dropped in the cross face.
After everything these two men have been through.
We're going to free the arm and does just that.
A lot of interesting matchups on this show so far. I like how this is all kind of panned out. This would be a good matchup. And I also like that a lot of the big names haven't shown up, because when they do pop up in a feud, it'll make things very interesting.
Of that one from all the way over here.
Oh, snap bear.
Classic sport.
Is it enough here? A kick out before three. This could be a tipping point in this match. I don't think there's any love lost here.
Certainly seems that tensions are rising, Michael.
I have a feeling we're only seeing the beginning, Byron. Whoa!
What was this? What is this?
Oh, this is turning into a real Donnybrook here.
I
This superstar's rocked, and this superstar apparently has had enough
what?
Of this.
Claudio's is dipping out. Away.
Discretion's the better part of valor.
How about calling it a retreating?
Whoa!
Oh, Brody, there's Brody. What? So Brody comes and beats up Claudio first.
There's no escape for this superstar.
Yeah, they're going to have to see this match through the end.
Oh my gosh.
He can end it here. The shoulder just gets up.
This is weird.
For comfort.
So why did Brody help Swerve? Swerve in the House of Black? Because the House of Black, I do have him on here as a faction. Oh, okay. Interference almost doesn't matter right now because Claudio's whipping his ass. I don't know what that move is.
There's two! Oh, somehow managed to keep this match going.
He is revving up the engine. He's not going to let anything stop him.
Swerve caught Claudio. Oh my gosh. What is this? Oh, what is this?
It's it.
That was incredible.
Unbelievable presence of mind.
I thought he was like, I can't tell if it's anger in the eyes of the fact that he hasn't finished this, or if it's disbelief that his opponent is still in this. Any superstars are going to show any quit at this point. Never say die attitude on full display. And we just saw some serious offense. Oh, diving hammer strike.
Drops a knee.
He's just taking a moment to simply remind everyone why he's simply the best.
Top up.
Oh.
50.
That was crazy. Oh, and Claudio rolls out. Oh no, oh no. Oh no. What's that mean? Swerve is leading.
Just on the wrong side of every maneuver.
to his feet, but he won't like what's coming next.
Oh no, another one.
That's finding any which way to topple the competition. Hurling your own body like that is insane.
This is getting wild.
Stomping right on their face. And it was already to a frightful purpose. The counter. He got tired of being pushed around and wants to gain the advantage now.
Tired of being pushed around.
Valley driver. No surprise that what we're witnessing is trending. Forget trending on social media. The motion in the arena is charting on the Richter scale. The referee continues the count. May call it soon. Start counting, Saxton.
One, two, three. After this banger, Claudio can do this.
I think you're right. Rotating vertical suplex. Nicely done.
So who's the crowd rooting for here? Seems like Claudio.
Crank in the head.
Okay, so Brody steps in on this match to begin a rivalry with Claudio. So now we have that. Maybe House of Black versus Blackpool Combat Club. Maybe a merge later, the House of Blackpool Combat Club. But we definitely have a little rivalry here with the these two factions, it looks like, maybe. I like it. Instant classic, that was a great match. 4.5 stars. Oh, that's a good one. Okay. I don't know why Lee Moriarty's coming out last here. I don't know how they do the three ways. I think it goes Kenny, Preston, Moriarty on the entrances. I gotta find Battle Cry, but the actual, oh, without the full intro. I don't want that. I'll play that. And then Preston Vance. It's weird. I don't know what order it's going with. I don't even know if I know this song. I know Tiger, Tiger, Tiger.
This is going to be good.
No, it's the Preston Vance.
Is a that's dumb. Threat match. Making his way to the ring from Michigan, weighing in at 240 pounds.
Take a look at the talent in competition here. You can see exactly why the WWE.
Preston Vance kind of looks like Ron Rickles or something. Is this what he's saying? He looks good though. This is actually good. Somebody back in production effed up, played Kenny Omega's music. They were confusing. Alright. Now Kenny Omega.
And his opponents. First, from North Carolina. Weighing in at 218 pounds.
I can never start this
Omega!
Theme, right?
Not since John Cena have we seen a superstar as resilient and perseverant as this one right here.
I could not agree more. Give me a break. Cena may never give up, but you two never give up when it comes to hyperbole.
It's pretty good, Kenny Omega. I know there are some other good ones out there, but I did get this one. I know he's a little cut. I changed his body a little bit, but...
He is in perhaps the best shape of his career, and he will need that with the competition level this high.
I think he's starting to look like that. He kind of got the same visuals, right?
And from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, weighing in at 185 pounds, Lee Moore E. Marty.
I
heard this one backstage talking up their own work non-stop. Well, why don't they get in the ring and prove it, huh? That's what they're doing right now, Corey. Well, good. Let's see what they've got then. A man who always considers himself main event material, an uncrowned champion. He wants to show exactly why here tonight.
Right.
A little one-on-one action here. A triple threat is possibly one of the most challenging matches a superstar can agree to.
He said a little one-on-one action, and then he said a triple threat.
No friends. And even if you were friends beforehand, a triple threat match makes enemies of everyone.
It's easy to overthink going into this match, but the best way to ensure
it's not one-on-one, dude.
Here
it's one-on-one.
Is to adapt to every moment.
Oh, shoot. Jack.
Oh, my. Alliances in this situation don't last long. Let's see how quickly this devolves. Implanted by the DDT. Twists the arm and a big boot to the guts. What's it going to take? It'll take more than that to hold him down.
So there's been nothing about the implications of any of these matches so far. I mean, I think that's for us to determine. But I just kind of wanted to see what kind of pairings that this AI would throw together.
He leaves the ring and there's no countouts in this one. Perils of this match that superstars must be concerned with.
Well, this is the type of setting where you must beware of outside interference. The sleeper is cinched in, and you can see little by little the opponent is fading.
He's lost some of his win now. Early to back suplex. No! Kick to the spine. Wrenching the arm. DDT! He's looking for an implement of destruction under the ring.
Forgotten triple threats and no DQ.
This won't win the match, but it's doing a lot of damage.
Oh, the pressure on the left knee. He's trying to fight it. He's trying to break out and does it.
Lee just fell.
Down by the DDT.
Oh, you can tell he's feeling it now.
This is a good lead there. This fight is pumping him up.
Throws the opposition back into the ring. Running super kick.
Someone just lost a tooth.
He's absorbing some tough hits now.
This should come as no surprise. In a havoc-filled triple threat, you're going to take some big hits.
Oh! Lands a knee. Toss.
Oh.
Knee right to the jaw.
The hard way suddenly more already with the
placed into the corner. Wicked.
This is not going to end well.
Will it be? And he breaks up the pinfall. Beautiful takedown into the Achilles lock. What a unique submission maneuver here. Look at the pain his opponent got. This one should have been over. But he breaks.
They're getting
the
Lee Moriarty over here because he's getting a match with two dudes way bigger and. I don't know about better impression. Definitely, he's
outside of the ring.
He's
now
an underdog.
What's
here.
The plan here? He'll take things into the ring.
And did you hear the impact of that? Targeted stop to the arm. Big ball.
He's earned it.
Trap the arm. Into the neck break, and there's the cover.
Uh-oh.
That could have been it right there.
Kenny says nigh.
And look at it from Kenny.
Oh, he's got the right back up. Lee's dead.
He saw it coming. Taking advantage. Hooked up. Nothing fancy there. Spinning
your knocking. Oh, they're both up now. Oh my gosh, Lee just got up from the Winged Angel for them like 15 or 20 seconds. Definitely don't know if that's possible.
Wrenches the arm. Beautiful. And he wants nothing to do with any of that.
He really just knows so.
Essentially. Running knee.
He's getting a huge boost right now from all those chants and cheers.
Oh. Eyes in the back of his head. Kenny Omega.
Crossing the legs into a patella brainbuster.
Turning the tables there.
Start counting, Saxton. One.
Didn't you watch that last match, Preston? I already did this spot.
Rotating vertical. Oh. Nicely done.
Oh.
Able to sidestep it. Thrown back in under the ropes. And a well-executed move we just saw there.
And this has got to be it.
And still in this.
inhuman at this point.
What are you doing, Kenny?
Here we go again.
Oh. That's his finisher. Oh, no. And Preston does the turn. More Hardy is down again. But he gets back up after the low blow. Uh-oh, it's Preston got. Is this it?
He's looking shaky at best now. Not what you want to see by any means.
And a stop to the gut, too. Heading back to the ring. Military press.
Situation is.
And what a maneuver we just saw there.
Will that be it?
Stop to the tummy.
Stop to the dummy. Oh, shit. Oh, there it is.
That's
so fancy. Definitely not the fancy.
Scouting, knowing how to answer a counter with a counter of your own. Boot to the stomach gives them separation. He gets back into the ring. Skull-rattling. Eye on the counter.
Pulls their opponent in.
Kicked right in the chest. Oh, that was a cool angle. He's coming somebody. Moriarty. After another. No way. It's not matter. That's his finish. He just got it with the finish. Kenny. Out of the frame. Oh man, how did that happen?
The WWE Universe giving him an extra shot of adrenaline.
Get him.
Hoisted up on their shoulder. Death Valley driver. And this is gonna be it.
He can just remember the DVD. I guess he can.
Seize the opportunity in this triple threat match.
I guess he can.
Here is your winner, Kenny Omega! Quite the impressive victory, coming out on top against two very capable, very prepared competitors. To win a triple threat match, you need incredible skill, instincts, or luck. Dare I say, tonight's winner showed all three in victory.
Kind of weird how it ended, but whatever, I'll take it. All right. Kenny. But a good showing by the other guys as well. Got some guys over, so Jeff got a dub. Hook got a count out dub. Adam Cole got a dub. Claudio got a dub. Like it. Upcoming title match, Claudio. Okay, so we have a potential championship situation between Claudio and Brody. the vacant tag titles are on the line. Are you about to have a makeshift tag team here? Vacant tag titles again. So, I don't know. We might have some tag titles situation going on. What happens if I hit B? Okay. Let's do something. ECW Old School Referee. Thought that was established. Again, just to make sure. That would suck if that doesn't fix itself. I created myself. That show. Let's, I guess, move on to the next show and see what happens. Yes, which will be Rampage. What? So we do got La Facción Ingobernable here with Rush and Andrade, but we got Penta and Daniel Garcia. Interesting. Penta taking Daniel Garcia under his wing, maybe? The tag titles are vacant. Everybody's trying everything, I guess. Wow. Didn't they just have a match? Or no, it was Ethan Page and Juice did Hook. So Juice gets another match now with Adam Cole. Okay. What? What? Okay. The Young Bucks versus Pac and Jay White. They pretty much look like brothers. What do we call that tag team? What do we call these tag teams? I don't know. But it might not even be the same the next time I go to it, because that's been one thing that's been happening, is sometimes I'll get out of it. And then I'll go to the next thing and, we got some more rivalries going on here. Weird. Okay. Let's do not standard referee. You dummy. Okay. What was I saying? I don't remember. Damn it. I'll think of what I was saying in a second. Standard referee, you might ask. I did that every single time. Okay. What I was saying was, oh yeah, sometimes the when you go back in after you exit, the matches are completely different. So that could be the case here. Let's hit exit and see what happens. I'm just going to go back to it just to see, and then we'll be done for the night. Wonder if it's different hitting continue or hitting load. Okay, looks like it's the same. Yeah. Interesting. But this is what the random universe situation is all about, because I feel like this is what we want, is to see what matches it sets up for us, which it set up some interesting ones. The Penta and Daniel Garcia, we'll see. I have the Lucha Bros on here too. I don't have JAS on here because I don't have Hager, and for some reason I feel like without Hager, and I don't have Danny Magic and Angelo either, so I don't have the whole JAS, so I'm not even gonna do it. I'm just gonna kind of let those guys kind of free float and see what happens. I really only put on people like factions that I want to kind of implement on here, like BCC and you know, Bucks and House of Black and stuff like that. But definitely some interesting stuff here. No news before this show. Interesting deal. I'll work out getting the right kind of entrance for these guys probably in the interim before I record this episode of Rampage. But that's Dynamite episode 1. We'll do Rampage probably tomorrow or some heat. So that's it. Come back for Rampage episode 1.